Welcome to English class, Natvajan Agaraj World School. In the last lecture, we were discussing about poem and we were going through the poem. So let me give you a quick recap of the poem. First, about the author. This poem was written in Tamil by Chinnaswamy Subramanya Bharati and was translated into English by A.K. Ramanujan. So, the title of the poem, Wind, is the metaphor.
अगर कोई इंसान वीक है, so crumbling body
अकॉर्डिंग टू एवरी रिलीजन अलग अलग गॉड्स होते हैं. लाइक इंडियन ट्रेडिशन में अगर हम देखें सो सूर्य देवता होते हैं, इंद्र देवता ही मीन से. सो देर आर डिफरेंट गॉड्स इन एवरी माइथोलॉजी, इन एवरी कल्चर, हर ट्रेडिशन में. सो हियर इन तमिल ट्रेडिशन विंड को गॉड कहा जाता था, विंड को गॉड कंसिडर किया जाता था. So here is a reference of wind god, and the poet says that the wind god winnows and crushes them all. So winnows, now winnowing is a process, is a, you know it's a process that takes place with human effort. अब क्या होता है? Like there is a heap of, you can say wheat. अगर बहुत सारी wheat रखी हुई है, बहुत सारा गेहूँ रखा हुआ है, उसमें से आपको छिलका और ग्रेन अलग करना है. तो बहुत जोर से जब विंड ब्लो करती है तो छिलका इज वेरी लाइट, द हस्क इज वेरी लाइट, सो इट ब्लोस और उसकी यहाँ पे हीट बन जाती है एंड द ग्रेन फॉल्स डाउन बिकॉज इट्स वेरी हैवी. सो इट फॉल्स डाउन एंड उसकी हीट अलग बन जाती है. सो हियर विनोइंग, द प्रोसेस ऑफ विनोइंग से क्या हो रहा है? द विंड गॉड इज सेपरेटिंग द वीक पीपल फ्रॉम द स्ट्रॉन्ग वंस. वीक
फॉरेस्ट. अगर कोई फॉरेस्ट है जिसमें
So do this and the wind will be friends with us. The wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. This can be seen with the example. This can be understood with the example that I have given you just now. I gave an example about the forest fire and the fire that, you know, the fire of the matchstick. Matchstick ki fire bahut easily bujh jati hai jab ki with the wind, if the wind blows. And if there is a fire in the forest, it roars and it flourishes. वो बढ़ती जाती, flourish करना मतलब develop होना, बढ़ते जाना. His friendship is good. So the poet says that we have to adjust according to the wind. और उसकी friendship भी ठीक है, rather than being enemies with it. So अगर हम और weak होते जाएंगे तो हम enemy बनते जाएंगे wind के. And if we become stronger and stronger, the wind would be friends with us. And it's more important to be friends with the wind, and it's more beneficial that way. क्यों? क्योंकि wind will only affect us in positive way if we are strong enough. We praise him every day. So when we become stronger, जब हम strong बनते हैं, उससे भी strong बनते हैं, उससे भी strong बनते हैं. So we praise that thing because we are in the process of developing. That means हम कुछ सीखते ही हैं इन चीज़ों से. And we become stronger and stronger day by day. So hence we praise him every day. अगर human difficulties नहीं, humans की life में difficulties, struggle नहीं होगा, so won't they develop? No, they won't. Will they ever thank the, you know, will they ever thank God for what they have? No, they won't. Because they won't consider it to be utna important, right? So here through this poem, the poet gives us a simple message, jo kya hai, that human beings and every element of this universe should be strong enough physically and mentally to resist or to overcome with the wind, with the difficulties of life. Okay? And difficulties would not listen to us. They would not work according to us. We will have to work according to the wind. We will have to adjust according to the wind, according to the difficulties, to resist it. Okay? So now let me discuss about the literary figures, the literary devices that are being used in this poem. First is metaphor. So we can see that the whole poem is a metaphor. So wind itself is a metaphor. Wind stands for human difficulties, human obstacles, the problems that come in human lives. Hence, wind is itself a metaphor. Now, wind comes softly. Don't break the shutters of the windows. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw the books on the shelf. Here, the word don't is getting repeated in the beginning of the sentences, you know, one after the other. So, जब भी sentence के starting का word gets repeated in the consecutive sentences, उसके नीचे वाले sentences में जब वो word repeat होता है, this figure of speech is called anaphora. Okay, so can you see another example of anaphora in this poem? It's very very simple. Yeah. You, you and you. This is again an example of anaphora because the first word of the sentence is getting repeated in the consecutive sentence, in the next and next sentences. Now, very clever and poking fun at buildings, great crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wall. So the word crumbling is getting repeated. So you know where लेकिन उसको हम किसकी जगह पे कर रहे हैं, किस इससे सिंबलाइज कर रहे हैं, वो ह्यूमन, राइट? सो दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट द चैप्टर एंड दीज वर सम ऑफ द फिगर्स ऑफ स्पीच यूज्ड इन दिस पोएम. थैंक यू.